Food Label Secrets. Artificial sweeteners, the natural products. There are several types of artificial sweeteners, and the claims made about their benefits or dangers are among the most prolific and outrageous we've ever come across. Hundreds of websites are dedicated to pointing out dangerous side effects, but much of the information they present is just plain wrong. Facts are misquoted, studies are ignored, and the lies coming from both sides are too numerous to count. So let me ask you a simple question. Do you willingly put poison in your mouth every day? Let me repeat that. Do you willingly put poison in your mouth every day? Yes or no? Well, if you brush your teeth with any of these and many other popular brands of toothpaste, you do. Take a look at the warning label. It says, warnings, keep out of reach of children under 6 years of age. If more than used for brushing is accidentally swallowed, get medical help or contact a poison control center right away. The poison in toothpaste is fluoride. In small amounts, fluoride-containing compounds are used to prevent tooth decay, but in large amounts, it can cause sickness or even death. Now read the label of any artificial sweetener. You'll notice none of them suggest you should contact poison control if you actually swallowed them. Some artificial sweeteners do have negative properties. That's why we're just going to share the facts so you can make an informed decision about which, if any, you might want to use. There are two artificial sweeteners from plants. The most well-known is stevia. Stevia comes from the plant known as Stevia rebaudiana. There haven't been many studies carried out on stevia simply because it's a plant extract and can't be patented. Major corporations don't want to spend the money to prove it's safe without being able to protect their investment. But there was one company willing to take a bet on it. Sweetleaf started importing stevia into the United States in the 1980s and promoting it as a natural sweetener. Unfortunately, they were too successful. In 1991, the Food and Drug Administration acted at the request of an anonymous complaint. The United States Department of Agriculture labeled stevia as an unsafe food additive and restricted its import. But the FDA couldn't stop Sweetleaf from selling stevia unless they proved that it was unsafe. So the FDA allowed it to be sold as a dietary supplement. Dietary supplements require much less testing than food additives. You can notice the label. Companies sold it as a supplement in convenient sugar-sized packets. The word sweetener was nowhere on the package. Everything changed in 2008. After years of lobbying, Sweetleaf Stevia was reclassified and considered generally recognized as safe, or GRAS, after two separate and independent panels of scientists determined stevia was a product safe for human consumption. Now the word sweetener could replace dietary supplement on the label. Some large companies were quick to take advantage of the new rules, and two new stevia products were released. Cargill and the Coca-Cola Company released Truvia, while the Whole Earth Sweetener Company, a subsidiary of Marisant, and PepsiCo developed Purevia. Truvia is marketed as nature's calorie-free sweetener, and Purevia prominently displays a leaf in reference to the stevia plant. But you have to read the ingredient list. In fact, the primary ingredient in both of these products is a sugar alcohol called erythritol, not stevia. That's something I'll tell you more about in the sugar alcohol section in another video. That doesn't mean Truvia or Purevia are bad choices, but if you're looking for pure stevia, read the ingredients and make sure that's the only thing listed. Now, there have been a couple studies that showed potential problems with stevia, but upon inspection, both were administering doses of stevia that were significantly higher than would ever be consumed. Stevia has not undergone the extensive trials that other artificial sweeteners have to prove their safety, but it has been used for decades in many countries, such as Japan, without any reported ill effects. If you're looking to cut back on sugar, but still want something sweet, Stevia sweeteners are reasonable alternatives. The bottom line? Stevia sweetener is safer than too much sugar. The other natural product is something called Thaumatin. Thaumatin are natural sweeteners first isolated from the catemphe fruit of West Africa. You can see one here enlarged from the Thailand website. The Thailand Food Company and the United Kingdom began extracting Thaumatin from the fruit in the 1970s and selling it under the brand name Thailand. The United States Food and Drug Administration considers Thaumatin to be generally recognized as safe, but they only allow it to be marketed as a dietary supplement or flavoring agent. The FDA does not allow Thaumatin to be sold as a sweetener or food additive. In other words, you can put it in food and it's okay, but if a company mixes it in food, it's illegal. Because Thaumatin is a naturally occurring substance, it's unlikely that any company will step up and carry out the additional testing needed to get it cleared as a food additive. Thaumatin has been shown to have no adverse effects when consumed by humans, but it has not undergone the extensive trials that other artificial sweeteners have to prove their safety. It has also not been used extensively for decades like stevia. In the studies we were able to find on Thaumatin, it seems safe. And, just like stevia, if you're looking to cut back on sugar, but still want something sweet, Thaumatin, or the brand name Thaumatin if you can find it, appears to be a reasonable alternative. The bottom line? Thaumatin is safer than too much sugar. For the complete series, visit us online at foodlabelsecrets.com. That's foodlabelsecrets.com. Thank you for watching.